For the times when your mind needs to soar free, get away from the busy hustle bustle of life and come to a beautiful destination that is going to serve you a lot of fresh, fragrant coffee. Pack your bags, put on your walking shoes, and come to the Scotland in India. I'm talking about the paradise land of Coorg.
Welcome to this episode of Karnataka Tourism Presents India Explored Coorg. Coorg or Kodagu is a hill station situated along the slopes of the Western Ghats. The temperature here averages between 20 to 25 degrees through the year, making it the ideal climate for relaxation. But to ensure you have a vacation unhindered by rain and fog, it's best to arrive here between the months of September to March. If there's one thing that meets the eye here apart from its beautiful scenery, it has to be the acres and acres of coffee plantations. How I got here is, I took a flight to the nearest airport, that is Mysore, you could also do Mangalore, and then drove down to Madikeri, the capital of Coorg.
For those of you who don't know, the pleasant weather of Coorg combined with the fact that when it drizzles, the water drains down the hills really quickly, makes it an ideal destination for golf. And that is the real agenda here. We're here to attend the 107th Coorg Open Golf Championship,
which is organized by the Belur Golf Club.
From attending the championship to experiencing the Coorgi way of life, my list has quite the number of things to do.
On my checklist, settling into Orange County luxury resorts, experiencing the natural flora and fauna of Coorg, learning some golf, places of religious significance, coffee tasting, discovering the homestay experience, and attending the golf championship. So without wasting any time, I am headed to where I will stay for the duration of my vacation, and I couldn't have chosen better. True to the spirit of Coorg, I am surrounded by a 300-acre working coffee and spice plantation, with the lush Dubare Reserve Forest on the one hand and the Kaveri on the other. This is heaven. Things you'd like to know about Orange County. Between 2009 to 2013, it has been the recipient of many awards in the hospitality sector. The latest feathers in its cap being 2013 Asia's Leading Experiential Holiday Resort and 2013 Asia's Responsible Tourism Award. For those of you who like your itinerary planned, there are a whole range of activities for you to indulge in. As if the location wasn't enough, the accommodation does its bit to pamper the senses.
Welcome to your room, ma'am.
Thank you.
This is your living room, and here is your bedroom, and that's the way for your pool.
Thank you so much.
While the exquisite private pool villas built using the rust-red, hand-cut laterite bricks are inspired by the unique architecture of the Kudavas, but the icing on the cake for me is my very own private pool.
Well, this beautiful bathroom is begging me to get ready and freshen up over here. So that's exactly what I'm going to do and gear up for my long day of exploration. I'm going to see you guys in a little bit. Well, now that I'm feeling all charged up and rebooted, I think I'm going to start with the place that I spot the most civilization at. We're at the heart of Coorg and the capital as well, Madikeri. There's so much to explore over here that I can't wait to begin. Let's get started.
Madikeri was also known as Merkara. It was the Haleri kings who ruled Coorg from 1600 to 1834 AD who made Madikeri its capital. First on my list here is the 19th century wonder, the Omkareshwar Temple, which was established by Linga Rajendra II with Mughal style architecture. According to legend, the king put a pious Brahmin to death unjustly and the spirit of the priest began tormenting the Raja. On the advice of his Diwan, the Raja built the temple to appease the Brahmin spirit. And 193 years later, here I am, a tourist visiting this marvel. Next on my list is the Madikeri Fort. This was built by Mudra Raja, who was a Haleri king, in the 17th century. It was then rebuilt by Tipu Sultan, who named it Jafarabad. There is a church in its southeast corner, and in the northeast corner are two life-size masonry elephants. Today, this fort is a deputy commissioner's office, but it continues to remain a heritage site. Fresh air, coffee plantations, and the occasional waterfall are common sightings here. And speaking of waterfalls,
taking a detour of about 9 kilometers from Madikeri, I've come to visit the biggest falls here in Coorg, the Abbey Falls.
The Abbey Falls are the point where the Western Ghats meet the Kaveri River. There is a Kali Mata temple close to the falls, and coffee and black pepper tree plantations surround it. What a magnificent end to day one here.
Early start to my Coorg holiday here today, and I've come to have a look at some gentle giants who are supposed to be very popular with the tourists.
The Dubare Forest Reserve hosts a huge elephant camp situated on the banks of the river Kaveri. In ancient times, elephants were trained here for the Dasera festivities. In current times, these elephants will happily take you for a joyride in the forest.
The heart of Coorg is a little Tibet, which is absolutely beautiful. And what makes this place so distinctive? Well, it's got to be the Namsrolling Monastery, which is also known as the Golden Temple. I'm with Prema, the secretary of the Namsrolling Monastery. So could you please tell us a little about the place and the history of the monastery?
This monastery established in 1963. Yeah.
And how did the name come up, Namsrolling Monastery?
Actually, the name, full name of this temple, this monastery is Thekchok Namdol Shedup Tarjeling.
Oh, can I try repeating that?
Thekchok
Namdol
Shedup
Shirjup
Tarjeling.
Ling.
Yeah.
Okay, so Namsrolling.
So it's a short form, you can say Namdoling.
Okay. Okay. And could you tell us a little about the Golden Temple that we also
The
see?
Golden Temple, actually the name is our informal monastery. It was Pema Sambha Buddhist Vihara.
What is the kind of work that has been done over a period of time?
In Tibetan Buddhism, there are five sets. So this set is Nyingma, the oldest one.
Okay.
In particular, in India, this institution is largest and famous also. Okay. They come to here, learn Buddha Dharma, and they were course 9 years course.
So I can hear music coming from the Golden Temple. Mm-hmm. What is happening inside? Can we go take a look?
Yeah, of course. It's daily basis. The prayers going on.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm humbled by the spirituality and magnificence of this place. Here are a few things for you to do apart from my own checklist while you're in Coorg.
48 kilometers from Madikeri is what is considered to be the source of the river Kaveri, the La Kaveri. This is also a place of religious significance to worshippers of the river. The first dam ever to be built on the river Kaveri was the Harandi Dam. It is 47 meters in height and 846 meters in length. I, on the other hand, am headed to experience what every traveler to Coorg must experience, a homestay. I meet with Akhilesh Basappa, owner of Javamane Homestay, and Mustafa, the manager, to get details.
So tell me something about the history of the Javamane property. What's it been like?
Well, basically, my father acquired this property around 10-15 years ago.
Okay.
And on this property, there was his house. He got the idea of converting it to a homestay. And at the time also, the Karnataka Tourism had promoted planters to start homestays to add to the income. That basically.
So is it a very common concept? Like, are there a lot of homestays over Coorg?
Approximately around 300 to 400 homestays.
Wow.
It is a very popular concept.
So how do you like market your specific property?
Initially we started off word of mouth, but now we have a website.
Okay.
Like several other homestays also do.
Okay.
So that's our basic form of marketing now.
How big is this place?
This specific place can accommodate comfortably 8 people.
Okay.
Yeah, around 8 people, but it can also do around 10-12.
If you want to get the real taste of Kodagu, don't miss the home-cooked meals a homestay will serve you. I don't know of you, but the scenic surrounding of Javamane are sure to make me come back here when in Coorg next.